Oh, you're the newcomer. Is it true that you've been to the Demon Lord's country? Until just recently, I was an attendant to Princess Gwendolyn in the castle.
That's her. I'm glad she's still alive. How can we collect the coins if we don't even know how many there are?
Courage takes many forms. We need the courage to find needles in a haystack the size of the world. All of us are searching together.
Oh, you're better now. I heard about King Valentine. He used to be such a great king. 'Tis unfortunate that he changed. This happened about when he made the coins.
Welcome! What can I get you today?
Is there something you need?
Is something wrong?
Meryl! Run! The goblins are invading! Here they come! Hurry!
Oh! I got away! That cowardly ball of fur! Let's take all their coins! There must be some around.
Whoa! Hold it, bunny! I gotta cut those ears off!
No, 'tis better to skin them and make a nice fur cloak. Ah! Stop!
This is Pooka territory. Get out, goblins!
What are you saying? This is our land! We're citizens of Valentine! We're entitled to this land!
Stop talking nonsense.
No, it's true. Pookas with evil hearts are turned into goblins. But I don't know why they would act this way. The coins must be given freely in order for the spell to be broken. Stealing the coins won't help.
We know that. After all, our king cursed us. But King Valentine ordered us to do this.
King Valentine?
This isn't our idea. But we can't just let you Pookas be the only ones who get to be humans again. But if we toss the coins in the lava in the Fire Kingdom like the king said, it'll glorify your crying faces forever!
Wait! Meryl, are you all right?
Oh! You can't let them... If we lose the coins, then we will never return to our old selves.
treasure, okay? Good. You understand? I mean, I'll give you a good deal on it.
Restaurant. No building, No problem. This is unbearably hot. A cold meal would be great for here. Now then, what do you want to order? As you wish. Sorry for the wait. Is there anything else you want to order? Thank you.
wonder. I don't have any coins. Really, please don't kill me.
Restaurant. Call and I am at your service. This is unbearably hot. A cold meal would be great for here. Huh? A new recipe. Allow me to add it to the menu. Now then, what do you want to order? Very well. Leave it to me. Enjoy your meal. Anything else you want to order? I await your further patronage.
Thank you.
You again? You always interfere. Those stupid goblins were all talk.
You are a king, are you not? Why would you choose to make your citizens suffer?
Those coins are mine to spend as I please. Very well. Let me tell you a story. Long ago, there was once a benevolent king with extraordinary powers. In order to keep his people happy, he put his power into the money, so all shared it. But what happened to him? Instead of thriving, the country was destroyed by a traitor. And instead of being mourned, I was called a mad tyrant who cursed my own country.
Didn't you use the cauldron against your own land?
It matters not now. Both the king's power and virtuous spirit have been infused into the coins. Once these coins were melted in the lava, my power would have returned to me. Those idiotic goblins! No, I shall let this go. I am a forgiving person. I still have hope. There is just one egg. Don't underestimate it. As the prophecies state, this is the egg of the dragon that dooms us all. In the Valentine prophecies, they call this snake a dragon, Leventhan.
A dragon's egg? So Wagner was referring to you when he said that.
My fury will burn the world! I will give you all my power! I entrust it all to your fiendish, brutal nature. Now hatch, Leventhan! Show us your strength!
Too long. The Netherworld's jewels, they suppressed my powers. I could feel them withering away while I was there. Who are you?
I am Prince Cornelius of Titania.
I see. Edmund's boy. I didn't understand why you carried the mystic sword of Titania. But now, I see why he gave you that patricidal blade.
Patricide?
I don't think he'd tell you. He killed his own father, King Galen, and took the crown.
My father couldn't do that! My grandfather was killed when the country was attacked by the demon beast. But my father was visibly frightened when he saw this sword in my hands. Huh? That voice that gave me the sword. It knew who I am. No, it can't be. That cannot be my grandfather.
King Galen must have wept in his cell. In addition to killing his own citizens, he was slain by his own son.
I had thought that after the attack, my father was the kingdom's savior and was given the crown. You say my grandfather was the demon beast? That's absurd!
He transformed via a mystic power passed down through the Titanian royal family. In order to fight my own intimidating army, Galen made a decision. Our military forces were crushed under his feet, and we were scattered. There was no time for anger. The beast continued to rampage through the kingdom for 7 days.
So my father destroyed the beast in order to save the country.
Be grateful for Edmund. If he did not claim to know the mystic power himself, I would have invaded Titania. Your land would have been easy to conquer.
So that's why he was stubborn.
This rumble is an omen. This is not good. If Onyx, the Inferno King, were to greet us, it would not be a good thing.
Wait, where are you going?
Into the flames of purgatory. I bid thee farewell until the world dies.
It's all here.
I see. I'm relieved. Cornelius, thank you for everything. I speak on everyone's behalf.
I would have been worried if I lost the coins as well.
You say you're from Titania? You shouldn't go home for a while. Not with the way the town by the castle is.
What?
Haven't you heard? A dragon has appeared in the castle town.
A dragon?
A woman has been chosen to be sacrificed to it. The king of Titania is unable to do anything, and the country is in a panic.
My father is ruthless.